Hi folks, I'm Voba. I'm a vocal trainer and a singer, and this is my channel about anatomical vocal training. Do-ka-do-a. Today is the last sequel of my series How to Stretch the Swallowing Muscle, which is phase 4 of the whole stretch. Now, in phase 1, 2, 3, we had this little choreography, which we will still stick to, of putting the sternum up, putting the tongue back, getting into a relaxed yawn, and then putting the tongue out. We will still use that, and now we will lower the sternum. Because if you did that exercise with a high sternum over a few months, then your sternothyroid muscle, your yawning muscle, will be strong enough to actually hold your thyroid in the sternum, in the jugulum, on top of the sternum, touching the sternum, even with the tongue fully out. The next level of difficulty is, of course, to take the sternum down, because you will be able to use the sternum when you're singing, but you don't want to, you know, have to always put it up there in order to have control over your thyroid, the cartilage. You want to have it maybe raised a tiny little bit, so that your muscle has an easier time to work, but you want the muscle to be strong enough to actually pull the thyroid down to the sternum, not to have to always lift the sternum up to the thyroid, right? So let me show you. You do the choreography, you put the sternum up, you put the tongue back so your thyroid cartilage goes down into the jugulum on top of the sternum, like this. Then you get into the yawn and you yawn, and then you put the tongue out. And watch this. Now, once you're there, you slowly start putting the sternum down. Until you feel, oh, now my thyroid cartilage is loosened up. It's not sticking to the sternum anymore. At that point, you stop, and then you try to put it back into the sternum, right? Like this. See how my thyroid cartilage pulls down back into the sternum? And you do that, you know, first you put it down a bit, wherever you can put it down. You know, you most likely, your thyroid cartilage will not come down to here with your sternum right away. It's gonna be maybe there, then after a few weeks, you can put it until there, and after a few weeks, you can put it really down and your thyroid cartilage is actually going to come down with it. Now, something else that I'm doing is I pull the tongue against it. So when I pull the thyroid down like this, the tongue does the opposite movement. It goes further out. Check this out. See how I pull the tongue against the thyroid, right? This means my thyrohyoid muscle is super stretched. And I also train the motor skills to actually be able to coordinate tongue out against thyroid down. This will really also free up your tongue for pronunciation and for lots of nice things that we will do later on. But it's very important for the tongue not to be stuck with the thyroid going down. You know, it should be independent of the thyroid. The tongue and the thyroid should be two independent entities that you can use independently. They don't. Your tongue doesn't have to go down when the thyroid goes down. Also, your thyroid doesn't have to go up when the tongue goes up or out, so that you can have optimal freedom and flexibility of the tongue and of the thyroid cartilage. And there you have the end goal. You want your thyroid cartilage to be able to touch, to sit down on the sternum when the tongue is fully out, like this. See how it comes down there? That's the end goal. Then you know your swallowing muscle is really flexible, is really stretched. That might take a few months, up to a few years. It's a process, you know, it doesn't just come like this. If it does for you, you're just lucky or you've studied a lot already. But this process will really free up your possibilities with your voice and especially with range, because that's the next thing. All of this stretching of the swallowing muscle was just to prepare you to have an easier time to achieve a big range, you know, achieve 3.5 or 4 octaves in your voice, legitimate voice, not whistle, squeaky sounds. So when you've accomplished that, your thyroid is way down there and your tongue is way out there at the same time, you will have accomplished a lot, and voila, your swallowing muscle is as flexible as it gets. Don't overdo the exercises. That's a very important thing that I actually had to learn, because since I was 11, I went to ballet school. And in ballet school, you have 6 days a week. You don't just work 5 days a week, you work 6 days a week. And you always train and do and stuff. And that is too much for the voice. Those little tiny muscles that you're working out, they really need 2 consecutive days break. So use a Saturday and Sunday to rest your voice, or a Tuesday and Wednesday. But if you do it Monday and Thursday, it's not going to work. It's not going to be enough time for your voice to actually rest and grow. Because we don't only want it to rest and recover, we also want it to grow, right? That's why we're doing exercises as singers. We don't want to stay stuck where we are, let alone go back. We want to advance. We want to go somewhere new, some place that we've never been to with our voice. Now, stretching the swallowing muscle has also some benefits for the thyroid, the position of the thyroid cartilage in your throat. Many people have a bit crooked thyroids, you know, maybe tilted to the side or tilted to the upper front. And so that makes the vocal cords really hard actually to freely vibrate. This strengthening the yawning muscle and stretching the swallowing muscle puts all these crookednesses back into equilibrium, so that your vocal cords can actually symmetrically vibrate and not, you know, be crooked in any ways. You know, they can just symmetrically vibrate once this is all loose and strong. I hope the content of this video could give you some valuable information. If you like the content, like the video down there and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more like this. I still have a lot in my backpack that I'm going to unpack, and I hope to see you soon.